radar here. And again, these colors represent toward and away. These red colors blowing away from Omaha. Green colors coming in toward. So here's your strongest rotation. We'll zoom in as tight as we can here. We're within the pixel nature of the radar here. You can see the way it looks right there. So we'll put this in the mode of the radar that displays that. And here you can see, again, red and green right next to each other in here, just to the southeast of Tecumseh here. This is the area that we're looking at, a possible tornado that's about 5 miles southeast of Tecumseh. That storm is moving to the east, and our residents over in Nemaha County of Nebraska, this is basically heading in your general direction. Now, this may or may not be a tornado, may or may not produce a tornado, but I'm pretty confident it's going to produce some very strong winds. That's typically what happens if you think about this as kind of a little mini low pressure area here. We've got low pressure right where there would be either a tornado or the circulation that's occurring right in through there. You tend to get strong winds blowing out on the south side of this thing, and so that's going to race across and into Auburn here probably over the next half hour or so. So I advise folks in southeast Nebraska to continue to follow that thunderstorm. Obviously, down here in southeast Nebraska, we continue to watch the tornado warning that goes until 1 a.m. for eastern Johnson County. There are lots of thunderstorms out there, obviously, and they continue to move off to the east. We've got a lot of rain occurring out to the west of the Omaha Metro. It's raining pretty good around Columbus right now, also around York. And watch that activity. It's all spreading to the east. We also have colder north winds already spreading in. Fremont's got the north wind blowing. You've got the north winds blowing over the area around Takema, north of Omaha. So all of that will spread across the area, too, as a cold front works in across the metro over the next 2 hours from west to east. The front is lined up right about here now. And it's, again, you got a pretty good north wind ahead of, going on behind that, a little southeast wind ahead of that front. And temperatures are still well up in the 60s here, 60s for the Omaha metro area in the mild sector ahead of that front. But once that front goes on through, the temperatures drop, and we will see the rain and thundershowers move on through here. But as I talked about, this is the threat of severe weather right now, basically along and ahead of that line here. So Beatrice still, Falls City still, Shenandoah, Maryville, Atlantic maybe. And again, currently tornado warning been issued now for the southeast part of Nebraska, the eastern part of Johnson County, the area just east of Tecumseh between there and Auburn. That's along Highway 136. Our residents of southeast Nebraska, weather radio is probably alarming. You should be hearing that information, and you probably should go to safe shelter, far eastern Johnson County, the western part of Nemaha County. We'll continue to keep you posted here at KETV Channel 7 with thunderstorm warnings and severe weather continuing here in the overnight. Once again, tornado warning in effect, though, until 1 a.m. eastern part of Johnson County. Small-scale, low-pressure area, warm front here, cold front there. The winds tend to really blow out strongly just south of that, the area of rotation that's occurring. So in and around Auburn, some strong winds blowing from the west now. And as I put this in the velocity mode of the radar now, the strongest area of rotation would appear to be right in through here, this north part of the county, the area kind of between Brock and Julian, would be most at risk for seeing a tornado. You've got a lot of open country down there, but again, it's at night. We've got to watch this stuff very, very closely here. So, again, we're following this because there is a tornado warning in effect for Nemaha County until 1:15, about another 8 minutes to go. But you just look at that thunderstorm, you can tell it's a nasty storm the way it's wrapped up. Let me show you again the velocity mode so you can get a sense for what's happening. If you're in Auburn, it would appear that you've got a strong gust front that's gone through there now, but probably if there's a tornado occurring, it's just to the north of there, this area close to the Odo County line. I wouldn't be surprised. Weather Service extends that maybe for the northeast part of Nemaha County, perhaps far southeast part of Odo County, and it would be south and east of Nebraska City, and then you're going to get over into Atchison County, Missouri, and Fremont County of Iowa at these. Now, there's also hail occurring with this thunderstorm. Not huge hail, but certainly the indication is on. There you can see you've got the severe thunderstorm watches lined up along the Kansas-Nebraska line, also along the Iowa and Missouri line on that latest image there. But you can see the huge amount of rain that's out there, and of course that's all advancing eastward. That will continue here in the overnight to continue to spread eastward. And the thing about this is that, of course, the severe weather threat is usually where you get the best inflow, or in other words, nothing going on south of you, and that's closest to that Kansas-Nebraska state line. Switch over to our HD radar source here, and this one is zoomed in on the Auburn area. This is showing you the same velocity mode that we were showing at the other one, and this right up here is where you've got the best couplet that's occurring here. And we really kind of track those couplets because what they're showing you is where you've got the best potential for strongest rotation. And this area right in through here now, just to the north of Auburn, and we've got that blue shade next to these red shades here. So that that area right along the highway, this is Highway 75 here, between Nebraska City and Auburn here, but the far northeast part of the county now there, and it's going to be crossing maybe possibly the extreme southeast Odo County as well. Let's go back to our classic Super Doppler 7 radar display on that one. Wider perspective, but again, watch the thunderstorms. They are tracking eastbound, and it's that one that looks like it's twisting that is most likely to be the tornado-producing cell. It's going to be one. Now, the National Weather Service has just gone with a severe thunderstorm warning for Atchison County, Missouri. You're going to get strong winds